What is up to all my creative friends out there in the world? Charlie Pangas here. Today I'm going to show you guys how to take your photos and turn it into a t-shirt design using Photoshop. And I'm also going to show you guys how to take that design and mock it up on a Bella Canvas blank. You guys already know how I work. I don't want to just design and show you guys how to mock something up. I want to show you the actual garment in person. So check this out. Well, not really in person, but you know, on video. So here is the 3001 Black Heather. So if you guys aren't already buying Bella Canvas blanks, definitely check them out. They are perfect. Like I said, they have a bunch of different styles, and this is one of my favorite ones. So I will link it in the description below. So what we're gonna do today is take a photo that I shot, and we're gonna turn it into a t-shirt design and also add our own little flavor to it and then mock it up on this blank that I just showed you. It's gonna be a lot of fun, guys. So without further ado, let's go and begin. Welcome to Photoshop, guys. So here is a photo that I shot of my friend. And what we want to do today is turn this into a t-shirt design. We're not just going to slap this picture on a shirt and call it done though. We're actually going to customize it. I'm going to show you guys how to also prepare it for screen printing. So we're going to get right into this, guys. The first thing I do is obviously drag my image into Photoshop, which I have already done. So it's right here. So this is my photo. Now we need to actually prepare this for screen printing. So what I do is I go up to image, I go to mode, and I go to grayscale. So we need to turn this into a grayscale first. And from here, what we can do is we can do don't merge, or we can merge it. It's up to you. And then we can rasterize it. We need to rasterize it. So discard that. So if you followed all the previous steps, you should be left with this grayscale image. And now we are ready to add some bitmapping. Now with bitmapping, we can add some halftones to this photo, which is what we need to do in order to screen print this photo. So what we're gonna do is go up to image, we're gonna go to mode, and then we're going to go to bitmap, okay? Once you click bitmap, it's gonna say flatten layers. We're gonna go and flatten layers. So click okay. Here's where all the fun happens, guys. So this is bitmap, right? And in bitmap, we wanna make sure the output is the same as the input, which it already is. It's at 300, the input's at 300. We're ready to go. So make sure your input matches your output. And once that all matches up, we can go down to method. And this is very important. We need to make sure this is on halftone screen. Just trust me, it needs to be on halftone screen, because if it's not, none of this stuff's gonna make sense or work properly. So just make sure it's on halftone screen. You're gonna go and hit that nice okay button. That's how you know we're getting somewhere in life. Hit that okay button. And once you do that, you're gonna see a halftone screen pop up, and it's gonna have all these weird looking things where it's gonna have frequency, angle, shape. It's gonna look complicated, but I promise you, it's not that complicated, okay? So let's break all these down real quick. So frequency is basically found by taking your screen mesh and dividing it by 5. That's the typical way of doing it. If you have another method that works for you, by all means, use it. If you don't know what your screen mesh is, just talk to your screen printer. If you don't work at a screen printing shop, and just figure out what their mesh count is and then divide that by 5, or they can even solve it for you. I'm pretty sure they might help you out with that, or not, I don't know. But anyway, so we have our frequency now. And for the angle, you can set it to 22.5. That's usually what works best for me. I've tried a bunch of different angles. 22.5 seems to work. If you have an exact way of finding out the angle, please let me know in the comment section below. I'm interested to learn about that, because I'm not quite sure how to get the perfect angle, but this seems to work really good. And I think angle really only affects when you have multiple colors too. You definitely have to worry about the angle a little bit more. Each color is gonna have a different angle, if that makes sense, so it doesn't collide with another color. It's kind of complicated to explain, but we're not going to get into that in this video. So we're going to move on. The shape is also, you know, up in the air with a lot of people. Some people use ellipse, some people use round. I use round, and it seems to work fine for me. So you can either try ellipse or round and see what works best for you. But for me today, I'm going to use round on the shape. And then after that, we're going to hit okay. We're getting it, guys. So now what we want to do is go to images. We want to go to mode. We're backing up now. So we want to go back to grayscale. We want to leave that size ratio to 1. And then click OK, and you're gonna see the photo is gonna, you know, kind of go back to its normal state. If you zoom in really close, you can see these little halftone dots, and that is exactly what we wanted. This is how we're gonna print this image. So now we're gonna move on, guys. We're gonna go up to image again, we're gonna go to mode, and we're gonna go back to RGB color, and we're gonna click nothing. You just go to it, and it actually just works magically. So I just went to RGB color, and it worked. Everything else stays the same. Our photo is almost ready for screen printing, but we need to do one more thing before we add our text and spice this up a little bit. And what I like to do is duplicate this real quick. So I did Command-G on my keyboard. You can also right click and duplicate layer. And we're gonna hide that background layer. Now I wanna get rid of this white background, obviously, because right now it's just a white background with the image. It's all flat, and I don't want that. So what I wanna do is go down to effects. We're gonna go to blending options. I'm gonna show you guys how to get rid of this white background super easy. Once you click on blending options, you're gonna see this little thing down here that says this layer. We're gonna go to the right side where all the whites are, and we're gonna hold an option and select the left anchor. And it's gonna be hard to see, but trust me, there's two of them. So we're gonna select the left anchor, we're gonna go to about 180, and we're gonna drag the right anchor now too. And what that's gonna do is it's gonna get rid of the white background. So if I convert this to a smart object now, I can actually make this any color I want. And I'll show you exactly what that looks like real quick. See, I can make that any color I want. Now, obviously it's a little light, right? So if I wanted to, I can duplicate this one more time and darken up the image, but I don't mind it being lighter. So the only other thing I wanna do is make a base layer because this is gonna be printed on black. So we need to make a white base. So all I have to do that is go to my rectangle tool and zoom in really close. And I actually should have created a duplicate copy of this photo first, but it's okay. So what I wanna do is just make a rectangle that's solid filled white, and that's it, and then no stroke. So we wanna get rid of that stroke. We're gonna go back to that box, and we're just gonna basically create a box all around it, right? We're gonna create the same shape box, the same size box and everything as our photo. Once you've done that, you can drag your photo layer above the rectangle layer, and now we are ready to start adding our own elements. But first, I wanna add a black background to this, so I'm gonna create a new layer. I'm just gonna fill it with black real quick because we're printing on a black shirt, or pretending like we are. So I have a black background, my photo and everything is ready to go. It's prepared for print, so I'm gonna group those together. So I selected both layers and hit Command-G on my keyboard that grouped them together, and we can name this photo layers or whatever. And then from here, what I wanna do is hit T on my keyboard. We're gonna type out some text. So I'm gonna type out street photography, all caps. Street photography. So I just typed out street photography, but it's in the wrong color. It's black, so it's matching our background too much. So all I have to do is double click on the street photography text right here in the layers palette, and then I can just change the foreground color to the background color, which is white. And as you can see, now you can actually see it. So what I wanna do now is just basically hit Command T. We're gonna resize this. So it's gonna fit the entire width of our photo. We're just gonna copy the width of our photo, and that's close enough. And then from here, I just wanna grab my logo real quick and I'm gonna drag it in. So we're just adding a little bit of a personal touch, nothing too crazy. And I'm just gonna add a color overlay and I'm gonna make it white. And I'm gonna resize it. We're gonna make it tiny. We just wanna put it at the bottom here. Now we are ready to go, guys. So I'm gonna mock this up for you. So what I wanna do is select all the layers. I'm gonna group these together so I know where it is. And we're gonna name this design photo, whatever you wanna name it, it doesn't matter. And we don't wanna group the background, the black background. So we're gonna hide that. Once you grouped all your layers and you have a transparent background, all you wanna do is do Command A, and you wanna go to Edit, Copy Merged, and we're gonna go to our mock here, and we're gonna basically resize it. So I'm gonna put it on the mock to show you guys what it would look like if it was actually printed. So we're gonna resize that quite a bit actually. And then from there we can even lower the opacity. So by mocking up your design, you can really see what it's gonna look like on a shirt. And I think this design looks really cool. I would definitely wear it.
That, my friends, is how you take your photos and turn them into t-shirt designs using Photoshop. And I took it a step further by mocking up my design on a Bella Canvas blank. The one I used today was the 3001 Black Heather from Bella Canvas. Awesome blank right here, guys. If you guys own a clothing line or you want to start one, definitely consider buying wholesale blanks from Bella Canvas. Their links are in the description below. Guys, I had a lot of fun making this video. I know you guys love the merch design videos. I have a lot of fun filming these merch related videos with you guys. And if you guys like them as much as I do, hit that thumbs up button as hard as you can. If we can get like 300 likes on this video, I will literally die of happiness. So let's see if we can get 300 likes. And if you guys enjoy my photography content and my vlogs, definitely consider subscribing to my second channel. I will link that in the description below as well. But guys, thank you so much for watching. Keep creating, keep being awesome. I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace.